નમસ્કાર, હું આદર્શ છું. વેલકમ ટુ આદર્શ એજ્યુકેશન સોસાયટી.
ડિયર ચિલ્ડ્રન, ટુડે વી હેવ ટુ લર્ન ઇન સ્ટાન્ડર્ડ 10 સબ્જેક્ટ સોશિયલ સાયન્સ ચેપ્ટર નંબર 20. તમે મુક્ત ચેપ્ટર ઇઝ સોશિયલ પ્રોબ્લેમ ઓફ ધ ઇન્ડિયા એન્ડ ધ ચેલેન્જીસ. વોટ વોઝ ધ ની મુક્ત ચેપ્ટર ડિયર ચિલ્ડ્રન? સોશિયલ પ્રોબ્લેમ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા એન્ડ ધ ચેલેન્જીસ. Now, dear children, you know very well that in the previous lecture, we have to learn about the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes. After constitutional provision, in constitutional provision, they were given about the general provision according to the Article 15 and the according to the Article 29. And after we have learned about the special provision. Now, today, we have to start from learning about the provision only for the scheduled caste. Where provision only for the scheduled caste. So, dear children, you have to open the page number of your textbook 172. According to Article number 17, which one, dear children? According to the Article number 17, remember the name of the article. So, according to the Article number 17, untouchability is totally irrespective. Whatever the untouchability is, there is this totally untouchability is totally irrespective. And its practice in the form in the prohibited. Any disqualification imposed due to untouchability is considered to be the legally punishable crime, which is known as a legally punishable crime. Dear children, untouchability is considered to be a legal punishable crime according to the Article number 17. After dear children, they were given about the according to the Article number 25, this provision for the scheduled caste. According to the Article number 25, states are given the right to frame a law or continue any existing law. What happened then? According to the Article number 25, now states are given the rights to frame the law or continue any existing law which permit the public institution for the social welfare or the reformer to keep the Hindu religion institution is open to all the Hindus. Here the word Hindu include Sikh, Jain, Buddhist in the Hindu religion institution, including all the religion institution of the Sikh, Jain and the Buddhist. Now next one, dear children, they have given the provision only for the scheduled tribes. Which one? This is the provision for the scheduled caste, ST category. Now they have given the provision only for ST category, and this provision are according to the Article number 195. Which provision, dear children? Here you have to remember the article. Be careful. Here the Article number 95, they have given the provision for the scheduled tribes. According to the Article number 195, empower the governor of the state to impose the restriction in the interest of the scheduled caste or the right to the unrestricted movement. Now what happened then? Here according to the Article number 95, empower they given the governor of the state that they have to impose the restriction in the interest of the scheduled caste about the right to unrestricted movement of the people to any region to settle down there, to acquire property or to carry out the business of the trader. Such rights given the authority to restrict the exploitation in the premium region about the land transaction, money lending and the other exploitation of the scheduled tribes. Why this article is required, dear children? This article is required for the land transaction, money lending and the other exploitation of the scheduled tribes and to frame the special law to protect them. Now next one, dear children, they will be given about the conclusion. Which one they will be given? They will be given the information regarding the conclusion part. Various schemes and the program have been started by the government for the development of scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes as well as for the backward classes. Now what happened, dear children? Here various schemes as well as the program are started by the government for the upliftment of the living standard of this category should the people. Now, which category should these people? For the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and the backward class system. For the development of their people, the government starting the various schemes as well as the program. That is why their condition is the improving. And that's why, because of the various schemes and the program, this people condition is improving. Many people have got an opportunity to progress socially, economically, and politically. And that's why, dear children, we can say that many people have got an opportunity to progress socially, economically, and politically by the government, various schemes and the programs. Now, next one, dear children, there will be one, the terrorism and global problem. Which one? Terrorism. Terrorism, it means antakvada. A global problem. Global problem, it means a vaishvik samasya. In the 21st century, dear children, we all are presently living in the 21st century. So, the 21st century, terrorism has become the problem for the human society. We know very well that in the 21st century, the biggest problem for the human being and the human society is the terrorism. So, in the 21st century, terrorism has become the problem for the human society. It is a global problem, and that's why we can say that the terrorism is a one kind of the global problem. Terrorism leads to the destruction of the human rights, bloodshed, destruction, fear, violence, and the unrest. Now, what happened there? Due to the terrorism, this terrorism leads for the destruction of the human rights, bloodshed, destruction, fears among the people, violence, and the unrest. Although the terrorism has no connection with any religion or sect, we remember, dear children, here the terrorism has no any connection with any religion or sect. Yet, by linking the terrorism with religion, terrorists are getting engulfed in the covardians and the hateful actor. Because of that, we can say that terrorism is a hindrance in the progress of the nation. It means maximum nation are facing the problem of the terrorism. And that's why the terrorism is a one kind of the drawback, hindrance, progress for the any nation. Terrorism is related with the violence, which openly violate the principle of the live and let live. The objective behind the any activity may be a good or poison, but terrorism cannot be considered as a one thing. What happened to the agent? Here, whatever the activity behind done by the terrorism, this activity may not be a good one. And that's why it is a one kind of the considered as a worthy one. Terrorism is an organized plan and deliberate the violent act. What happened to the children? Here, we can say that the terrorism is one kind of the plan, organized and deliberate violent act. Terrorism are engaged in violent the activity like suicide attack, throwing bomb, hiding the weapons, using them, kidnapping, hijacking of the planes, suicide attack, smuggling of the narcotic drugs, etc. Now, what happened there? Which kind of the things are included in the terrorism for their activity? In the terrorism are concerned engaged in the violent, the activity of suicide attack, throwing bomb, hiding weapons, using them, kidnapping, hijacking of the planes, suicide attack, smuggling, narcotic, drug, this all kind of the thing are the harmful for the society as well as the people. And already we know that the India is also the facing the problem of terrorism. Now, America is, so many European countries are there. Now, that's why you can say that this is the one kind of the global problem. And we have to solve the problem with the peaceful way. Rebellion and terrorism in India. Now, dear children, next topic, there will be even about the rebellion and terrorism in India. Rebellion, it means badwa or indemnity. What was the meaning of rebellion? Rebellion, it means badwa. Terrorism, it means antakvad in India. The line between terrorism and rebellion is very thin. What happened to the dear children? Even that, the line between terrorism as well as the rebellion is very thin. Now they were given in the difference form in your textbook. One side they were given about the rebellion and second one they were given about the terrorism. First they were given that rebellion is the national problem. Whatever the village in here, rebellion is which kind of the problem? This is the national problem. Which is the national problem? Rebellion. Why? On the another side, if you have to see, then we can say that terrorism is a one kind of the global problem. Syria, here you can say that terrorism is a global problem, that rebellion is a national problem. Second one, rebellion, it is a spring on the regional level against the whole government. Here, whatever, whatever the rebellion, rebellion it is barwa, rebellion it is spring on the regional level against their own government. While on the terrorism side, you have to see that terrorism, it is either against one country or against the other country. Now terrorism is against or their own country or against other country. It is spread at the international level. And we know very well that now the terrorism is spread at the international level and the maximum nation are facing with the terrorism problem. Now next we have to give up. In the rebellion, it is carried out with the help of the local people. Now what happened in the near? The rebellion is there. It is carried out with the help of the local people. Why if you have to see in the terrorism part, then terrorism they may or may not be get local support. But in terrorism, they may or may not get the local support for this activity. Next one. Development of state is suffering from the problem of the rebellions in the hindrance. Now what happened there? In rebellion, the development of the state is suffering from that problem. While in terrorism, the development of the country is suffering from the terrorism is one kind of the hindrance. So dear children, there will be even the difference between rebellion and terrorism. So the rebellion is a national problem while terrorism is a global problem. Thus, we see that rebellion is originated from the local dissatisfaction and there is no such restriction on the terrorism. Today, India is fighting against the internal rebellion and the terrorism. Now, what happened in the region? You can say that whatever the rebellion is there, this rebellion is originated from the local dissatisfaction among the people and there is no such restriction on the terrorism today. That's why we can say that India are fighting and facing the problem with the internal rebellion and the terrorism. Thank you, dear children.
Thank you for joining us.